One of the first questions you're going to ask yourself as you get through this worksheet is, should I be using an RMS, root mean square voltage, or should we be using the peak-to-peak voltage? Should I measure peak-to-peak? The answer lies in this. You're going to be applying an AC signal, and in this case it's considered just a sine wave. The voltage from this 0 volt point to that peak there, the amplitude, is what we will call the V peak voltage. And the voltage which will go from there all the way down to the peak on the opposite side, that there is the peak to peak voltage. Now, where would we use this? Assuming you wanted to find an instantaneous voltage at some time t, then you would use this expression with which you'll be familiar from your wave work possibly. That'll be the instantaneous voltage at some time t is the peak value times the sine omega t, where omega, of course, is relates to the frequency. Now, when you're doing oscilloscope work, it's much easier to find the peak-to-peak value than it is to find the RMS value. If you are working on an oscilloscope like this, then here you'll be able to find the peak-to-peak value quite easily, and from that you can calculate the peak value. But if you're using a multimeter like this, this multimeter actually gives you the RMS value. And from that RMS value, once again, you'd have to calculate the peak. And the relationship between the RMS peak-to-peak and peak values you will find in the manual. And you'll also see that this is dependent upon the shape of the wave. So that the RMS value for a square wave is not the same as the RMS value, say, for a sine wave or a triangular wave. Thank you.